We'll close this afternoon's session with an M-cubed minute video on a topic that often receives little attention in our society, humility. This team unites faculty from the Ann Arbor and Dearborn campuses, including art and design, libraries, business, and philosophy, as well as students from history, museum studies, and art and design. This cube plans to share its findings through its recent humility colloquium through an anthology for a public audience. Roll film.
Humility isn't really taught or encouraged among people in our society.
Part of the motivation for this is the very polarized cultural and social environment we have now, where people yell at each other, but they don't really understand or hear or empathize with each other.
The Cube started with my colleague, Rebecca Modrak, and her work investigating the work of farmers in the rural Midwest.
You know, the status was really like not at all on anybody's mind. It's a very different experience and culture than what I'm used to here in Ann Arbor.
We are having a colloquium. We're working hard to bring in some voices from outside of, you know, the academy.
So we're bringing New York Times columnist Charles Blow. And at a certain point, we realized that we hadn't invited anyone to talk specifically about Trump. And you know, this is a really dangerous sort of arrogance and a lack of protection to a lot of vulnerable people in the country.
So we have philosophers, psychologists, people from business.
One essential feature of humility is simply recognizing that even though I really think I'm right, I should have a knowledge that I might be wrong.
Often this misconception that if you're humble, that you're giving up power, that you're weakened somehow. Leaders who admit mistakes are more trusted, that their employees are more able to come to them, and those groups are more able to come up with solutions that work for the whole team. There isn't any area or any discipline that's not affected by humility or arrogance.
For the next 2 hours, we all have a great opportunity to put humility into practice as we participate in our massive poster session and learn from experts outside of our own fields. So I encourage you, ask questions. Ask questions that you might think are silly and put yourself out there. Over 200 cubes will be available to talk with you one-on-one about their exciting projects. And be sure to check out the hands-on demonstrations too, including snake robots and a digital library game. For an overview of the posters, you can see the agenda in your event program. You'll find details on each presenting cube with floor plans of the league. And you'll find posters in the ballroom, Vandenberg, Hussey room, and Michigan room. And did I mention that if you come to the poster session, even without presenting your symposium name badge, you can receive your own reusable M-cubed ice cubes. So enjoy the M-cube glow. Thank you.